Welcome to the App Circle 5-Minute Challenge. I'm Scott Stahl, Developer Relations Engineer for AppCircle.io. Today what we're going to do is take a look at how to set up CI/CD for your Flutter app, including automatically building on push, automatically running tests, and just in case you don't have an Android Keystore and want your app to be signed, we're going to create a new Keystore for you as well. Now, I do want to qualify one thing. When I say a 5-minute challenge, I mean 5 minutes from the time we log in until the time that the build begins after we push. We can't really control how long it's going to take to build your app because, well, first of all, we don't know how big your app is. And that's probably the single biggest determining factor. That said, let's get started. Now, the first thing we're going to see when we log in is the dashboard. Here you'll find a lot of different options such as build, signing identities, distribution, emulators, simulators, and others. Now these are all repeated again over on the left-hand side, so they're nice and easy to find. Today we're going to be working with build and signing identities. So I clicked on build, and we'll go over here in the top right to add new. I'm going to be very creative and name this test. Due to the camera, you're not able to see the drop down right now, but it does say Android, as you can tell right there. And our source code is going to be Flutter. Now we have our nice new build. You can click anywhere here. And now we bind the repository. One thing to know about binding a repo is if you're going to be doing a private one, you want to do this via SSH. Also, if you're doing a public one and you want it to build on push, you should not put the URL here. You should come over to here and use OAuth. So we're going to use OAuth, and we've already bound this GitHub account to this AppCircle account. So here is our repo, which is on GitHub, Flutter CI/CD test, and they're bound. There's our initial commit. And now we're ready to take a look at the configuration. We're going to do a debug build right now, going to output an APK, and we are going to auto build. Additional arguments. We don't need any for this particular build, but I do want to point out that if you are using packages that are not null safe, of course you have to build with no sound null safety, and this is where you're going to put that argument. So, right there, no sound, null safety. And there are an awful lot of packages still, unfortunately, that are not null safe just yet. We go over here to distribution. We're going to send it to ourselves, and we're going to auto-distribute. Now, this is going to cause a link to the artifacts to be emailed to us, and the artifacts basically means the produced files, such as your APK. We're not going to need any environment variables here, but we are going to be having a signing identity. Make sure we save that. But we don't have one yet. So this is where we come over to signing identities here on the left, and we generate our Android Keystore right down here and go over to add new. So we're going to generate a Keystore, and of course, we want to have all of our passwords, our alias, which I am going to creatively name alias. But I do want to point out the password is not password. We're not being quite that sloppy. So test ing is the last name. This is going to take a few moments. While this takes a few moments, let's go back and take a look at the build. And up here on this little menu, it's kind of a horizontal hamburger, which gets turned into a vertical hamburger. I don't know. I didn't do it. Don't blame me. But we can go over here into workflows and take a look at the default push workflow. We're going to want to do that because this is where we set up our testing. So we're going to edit the workflow. And here you see all the things that the virtual machine is going to do when it's instantiated. It will, among other things, install Flutter. And what we want it to do is run Flutter test. So we're going to do this, of course, after we install Flutter, and it's kind of smart to do it before we build. Why? Because if it doesn't pass the tests, why are we going to bother building, right? So let's make sure by clicking on the Flutter test right here, let's make sure that it will not continue with the next step if this step fails. So we just want to be sure of that. Now that all of that is set up, we can go back over to our signing identities, because we should have a key store at this time. And there it is, test ing. Save that. And guess what? We are now ready to go. So we pop over to IntelliJ here. And one thing I do want to point out in IntelliJ is that it doesn't make a whole lot of sense for me to show you that it works and everything passes. What you want to know is when the test fails, what's going to happen? Is it going to notify you? How's this going to help you? Well, we're not going to have our test punch the button 27,000 times. So clearly, this is going to fail. So we're going to do a commit. You do use commits, right? You use commits often, the way you're supposed to. That's right. So our commit is done. We shall now push. And with that push, there should be a build coming up. Oh, anytime. There it is. So that right there is basically it. We have set everything up. We've created a new signing identity so that the app is going to be signed on the Play Store. We have got automated testing and automatic build on push. So let's take a look here at what's actually going on in the build. On the right here is our build log. And in the build log, it will show you what's happening, such as Flutter being installed. It will show you Flutter Doctor being run. And it's also going to show you when the tests crash and burn. Okay, now, you're going to get a lot of red ink, or in this case, red screen real estate. And you should also get an email that tells you the tests failed. So why is this a big thing? Well, let's put it this way. Continuous integration. The whole point behind continuous integration is that you are committing and pushing often. This means your tests are being run often, but you don't need to sit there and stare at them. You push and get back to work. It's that easy. Everything else gets taken care of by the CICD fairies. It's all fairy dust and unicorns. And they take care of this for you, and they tell you if anything, I don't know, explodes, kind of like that. Yeah. So it's all gone wrong. Now you get notified. Here's the big point. Do you want to be the person who gets that error message and then has to dig through 6 hours of code at 3 o'clock on a Friday when you have concert tickets? Or do you want to be the person who committed and pushed after doing only a half an hour's worth of work, and now you only have a half hour's worth of code to dig through, and you'll be able to find the bug quickly, get out the door, and go enjoy your concert? I want to be person number two. I don't know about you, but yeah, I want to be getting out the door, especially on a Friday. So let's take a look here at exactly what happened. We have a nice big red section that tells us something went wrong, clearly. And the error is at our Flutter test step right here. Now, if we take a little bit of a scroll up, we can see that there is an exception caught by the Flutter test framework. And if we look up a little bit higher and look way out to the side, we can see that the following test failure object was thrown, and it expected one node in the widget tree to match what it was looking for. And instead, it actually found zero widgets matching 27,000. Well, we kind of knew that was coming. Also, if you take a look, let's see, counter increment smoke test. That will tell you right there which test was being run when things went wrong. And of course, if we take a look over at IntelliJ, we have counter increment smoke test. And that really is about all there is to it. As you can see, you set this up in about 5 minutes. You don't have to fight configuration files for a day and a half. And if you are pushing often the way you're supposed to, the unicorns working in the background will tell you if anything goes wrong. But otherwise, you just push and get right back to work and you don't worry about it. And finding bugs quickly gets you out of work on time on a Friday. And with that, I'm going to sign off, and you go enjoy that concert.